Hey, happy day, Pajamagrammas, your Horne-Ellstrom and curlers today on day 120 of the Daily Scare Share. Doing one thing a day this year that scares the bejeebers out of me or stretches my comfort zone. I don't know about you, but every once in a while, my life gets into a rut. I'm pretty old now, I'm a grandma, so I've had a lot of experience with different phases of my life. Phases where I run, like I feel like I'm running every day through my life, every second of every day. And I've had phases where I've just kind of coasted along. Well, in the last year or so, I've been in one of those coasting along phases. Have you ever been in one of those? And my daughter noticed it and said, "Hey, what's going on? You're coasting along. You're not doing what you should be doing. Get out of your rut." And she found this cool book on my bookshelf that it had for a couple of years, bought it and started it with a friend, but never finished it. We did it like we do a lot of things in life. Let's be honest. How many things in your life have you started and not finished? How many books have you got in your house right now that you bought that you've never read? I have a lot and I read all the time, but I always have a whole bunch more books than I could possibly read. So even I do that. I have books that I haven't read. I have a lot of new things. I have this little habit of buying new things, cool things like clothes or fun things for around the house and never using them. Do you do that too? We procrastinate with everything in our lives. We get into habits and we get into ruts. So this whole project, I'm doing a year probably of, because I had almost a full year of the book. I think I'd maybe done a week, maybe two of it. To get out of this rut, break free of the chains of the habits or the bad habits that are affecting my life. The negative thinking, the stinking thinking. I know we all got some of that sometimes. The routines and the things that just aren't serving me anymore. The clutter. Guys, I don't know about you, but clutter is a huge one for me. Clutter and stuff I don't need anymore. But that clutter and stuff could be an absolute gift to someone else. So I need to give it away to charity so other people can benefit from the things I'm not using. So what is our lesson or assignment for today? Well, it's just like yesterday. It's another one of those blank line scary ones. And today I kind of switched it around because it says goal and step one, just like yesterday. But as I was looking at those blank lines, I'm like, wait a minute. The goal, writing down the goal is step one. How many of you actually have your goals written down? Now, I write my goals down, but guess what? I don't have my goals written down or my updated goals written down right now. Well, they are now because I just did it this morning. But when I looked at this and was thinking about it, I'm like, I don't have my goals written down. My current objectives and goals right now are not written down. They weren't, but now they are. So today, I don't care if they're in your head. I don't care if you can see them and imagine them. You have got to write them down. My dad used to drill this into my sisters and my and even our kids' heads. Write down your goals. And I remember as he had brain cancer and died a few years ago. And as he was getting sick and he didn't even know it yet. We didn't even know he had brain cancer yet. All of a sudden he was talking to all of the grandchildren and really emphasizing things with them, like writing down their goals. And writing down their goals was one of them. It was one of the things that he needed to make sure that we all knew before he couldn't talk to us anymore. So please write down your goals today. Pick one goal for each area of your life and just write that down. That's it for today. Go out, make it an awesome day, and I will see you again tomorrow with another Daily Scare Share. Bye. Don't be scared. Just write them down. Nobody has to see them, just you.